From a child lifting a car off his father to donating a kidney to a friend, here are 10 stories that will restore your faith in humanity and make you feel warm and fuzzy inside. Number 10. Mosque welcomes churchgoers. When you see religion in the news, it's usually not a good thing. It's usually something about conflict and division. In this case, however, we got a nice story. In spite of it being the result of a devastating event that could have spelled disaster for churchgoers in Texas. The Universal Unitarian Church in Victoria, Texas, thought their days of worship were numbered this year after a car collided with the building, smashing through the sacred structure and causing an enormous amount of damage. They were left without a place of worship, but along came salvation from an unexpected source, the local mosque. The Victoria Islamic Center opened its doors to Christians so they could come together and share their place of worship. What's even more remarkable is that the Islamic Center is also being housed in a temporary portable building because it was razed to the ground by an arson attack in 2017. Instead of closing themselves off, both communities shared the love. You can help both churches with their recovery efforts via GoFundMe. Number 9. Worker gifted a Jeep. Big companies have a bad reputation for being obsessed with money and not very respectful of their workers. That may be true in some cases, but not when it came to Derrick Taylor. This hardworking 19-year-old from Alabama walked a 10-mile round trip every day to get to his job at UPS. Safe to say, he was going more than the extra mile to provide for his family. When his colleagues and managers heard about this superhuman effort, they decided to pitch in and take the load off. To Derrick's surprise, they presented him with a Jeep Cherokee to drive to work and filmed the result in a tear-filled video. This touching gift has transformed the young man's life. Now, instead of picking up blisters, he's picking up his coworkers. It's good to know that people care enough to be so generous to a regular guy who's just trying to make his way in the world. Number 8. Boy lifts car. Sugar City, Idaho resident Stephen Parker thought he'd taken all precautions when he jacked up his Toyota Prius to remove the engine. However, in a calamitous turn of events, the vehicle suddenly collapsed on him, crushing him underneath. His only hope was his son JT, and he was only 8 years old. His older brother, who was 17, had just gone back inside after cutting his hand. His father passed out, but somehow little JT found the strength to jack the Prius back up. He jumped up and down on the handle of the car jack with all of his might, which was no small feat since it had taken two men to get it up there in the first place. JT slowly raised the car off of his father and then finally was able to get to his older brother. JT was given an East Idaho Real Hero Award by the American Red Cross. The really strange thing is that JT hasn't been able to jack up the car again, even though he's tried. He says that his strength came from the angels of his grandfather and sister who were watching over. Number 7. Sit with us. We all remember those awkward times in the school cafeteria, trying to find someone to sit with and maybe even being ridiculed or worse, bullied for our trouble. If you've ever moved to a new school, the first couple of days are always the hardest. If you were lucky, you always had friends around, but a lot of kids are forced to eat alone. They also have to go through the humiliation of publicly looking for people to sit with. That takes guts at the best of times, especially when you're young. Thankfully, technology is filling the gap. 16-year-old Natalie Hampton from California has designed an app simply called Sit With Us. Launched in 2016, the app enables lonely or new kids to join an ambassador at their table. All you have to do is see who it is via your smartphone or device, and you're safe in the knowledge that you can sit down without all that terrible humiliation. Number 6. Pilot kidney transplant. Pilot Jody Harskamp of Alaska Airlines was used to danger up in the air. However, it was danger closer to home that caught her off guard when her house burned down in 2013. A woman Jody had never met, named Jenny Stansel, came over with a freshly made lasagna to keep her spirits up. The two became friends, and it turns out that Jenny was a flight attendant. Jenny had been battling chronic kidney disease for 15 years. She found herself on dialysis and in need of a new kidney. Guess who stepped up to offer a donation? That's right, Captain Harskamp. 4 years after the famous lasagna delivery, the pilot decided to help the flight attendant by giving her a healthy organ. The pair are now firm friends, and it was all made possible thanks to a fire, some Italian cooking, and one failed kidney. Jody often participates in marathons and climbs mountain peaks, so she's doing okay with just one kidney. The two are now passionate about raising awareness for organ donation. Number 5. Chloe Cares. She may only be 10, but Chloe Thompson and her Chloe Cares project are already a phenomenon. This young lady has made a big name for herself through her acts of kindness. Little she may be, but she clearly has one enormous heart. The charity distributes unique hand-sewn bags containing essential toiletries to homeless women to try to help them know that they are loved. It started with a neighbor in need, and then Chloe started spreading the love everywhere. A simple but effective gesture that won't find these individuals a home, but will let them know that someone is out there thinking about them. Chloe and her grandmother have produced over 1,000 care bags so far. She hand-delivers them to women throughout Los Angeles and Orange County. And the good work doesn't end there. Chloe has achieved all of this in a little over 2 years. She's now expanding her effort to include bigger projects, like a community center. Chloe Cares is now a registered charity, and she's hoping to get more kids involved and travel abroad to Ghana. No matter what your age, you can make a difference. Number 4. A new proposal. This next story is very romantic. If you don't like the slushy stuff and are thinking, oh no, then don't worry. This is a genuinely touching tale of marital devotion that you'll be glad you didn't skip through. Jim and Laura Koch from Iowa got hitched in 1990 and have been a strong couple ever since. But there were testing times ahead when Laura got diagnosed with breast cancer and had to undergo a grueling mastectomy operation. Jim decided to make a statement about his love for Laura, so he went for a surprising option. They'd already been married 20 years, but a week after her surgery, Jim got down on one knee and proposed again, something that put a big smile on Laura's face and made her feel truly valued. He even got a new ring made, which contained the diamonds from their original wedding band. Their children are extremely proud and admire the love and devotion their parents have for one another. Number 3. The Blind Traveler. If there's one thing you definitely need when traveling the world, it's your eyes and ears, right? Well, not necessarily. British backpacker Tony Giles has been breaking stereotypes by visiting different countries and experiencing them for himself in a unique way. Tony, also known as Tony the Traveler, has been roaming the globe for years. He was able to see as a child, but then at 10 he went blind and started to lose his hearing. He can hear a bit through hearing aids, which have helped him avoid elephant stampedes and getting run over by horses and carts. His goal is to visit every country in the world because it was the biggest challenge possible for a blind person. He was even caught up in the military coup in Mali and arrested while crossing the Ethiopian border. He's just reached middle age, but Tony has been to over 100 countries, including the USA, Israel, and Greece, where he met the love of his life. He has written several books and is always planning his next trip. Number 2. Meet the Mooks. Jack Mook used to be a detective in Pittsburgh, and in his spare time he would volunteer at a local boxing gym. It was there that he ran into two young brothers, Josh and Jesse, who were suffering from a troubled home environment. Sadly, their parents were experiencing substance abuse problems. Jack was so concerned that he eventually decided to step up and try raising the boys himself. In 2012, he became their foster parent, and then 2 years later, Jack went the whole way and was able to adopt Josh and Jesse as his own. In spite of bringing the brothers into a new family, he's keen for their former clan to be involved in their lives. Since that time, Jack has retired from the force, got married, and is now running his own boxing gym. This has hit movie written all over it, and guess what? The screenplay has already been written and the film is in pre-production, so keep an eye out. Number 1. Airplane ticket. Traveling anywhere these days can be pretty stressful and expensive, especially if you're traveling with children. A man went to check in for his flight at a Nebraska airport holding his 2-year-old toddler. The agent asked how old she was, and it turns out that she was 2 years old and 2 months. In theory, children up to the age of 2 can fly for free, and the agent argued that she was over the limit. He had booked the ticket way in advance, but there's no way to get around airline red tape. He now had to cough up $749 for the little girl. As you know, same-day tickets are expensive. He was hit with emotion and didn't know what to do. He said that he couldn't afford it and stepped out of the line and started making phone calls to see what he could do. Thankfully, a generous passenger was on hand to help when he got into difficulty. Debbie Bolton heeded the call and offered to buy the little girl a ticket. Debbie is a higher-up at company Norwex and decided to give away some of her hard-earned money to a very worthy cause. As far as she was concerned, she wanted to pay the fare and get out of there, but the incident wound up on social media, after which point there was just no hiding for this woman with wings. The juicy details landed all over the internet, and she got the attention she deserved for this inspirational gesture. Way to go, Deb! Thanks for watching! Do you have any nice stories you'd like to share with us? Tell us about them in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you soon. Bye!